The Fountain Valley soccer team started their season in rank 27 for all 3A schools in Colorado. 5 games into the season, their record amounted to 4 wins and a tie against Colorado Springs Christian School. Although things were looking bright already, their biggest challenge of the season was looming over them as they traveled to Denver on Saturday to play against the number one seed in the state.
Denver game was probably, I would say, the turning point in our season. It's when it really showed the team what they can do. They're number one team in the state. They're on a 25-game winning streak, I think, at that time. And for us to go into their home field and get a tie is huge. And I think that gave us the momentum and the confidence going forward against Salida, CA, and a couple of the others that we were going to have to face this year.
The Danes went on to win the next 4 games in considerable fashion, scoring 21 goals and conceding only 2. Next up was another huge challenge, Fountain Valley's biggest rival.
Losing to CA 3-2 a couple weeks later in overtime really showed that, it really solidified us. And it showed that we do deserve the respect and that we are a top team. Last year we scored our first goals against them, and then this year we were up 2-0 on them. And our team has definitely come a long way in the last few years, I think.
The Danes finished the regular season by adding another 3 wins to their name, including a notable win against a strong Vanguard team in a hard-fought-out game ending 3-2. Their record now amounted to 11 wins, 2 losses, and 2 ties, the best record Fountain Valley Soccer has had since their state final run in 2007.
It's been a long time since Fountain Valley's been ranked this high, going to state playoffs and actually getting to host. We earned the number 6 seed for a reason, and it's the way we play. It's going to be a long afternoon for them.
One down, good kick. Heads up on the foot, it's started, he scores! Yeah, just forget the wins. Sam Birmingham scores again. Borden and Frank Oliveri, Borden extends the lead. Will Grady gets the goal. Going hard, turning the corner, takes a shot and scores!
Next up, the Danes face Telluride, 22nd seed but more than ready to prove a point.
And the 22nd seeded Miners have taken a lead with under 19 minutes to go in this game. Play is onside, Ian in on goal, shoot, score!
Let's go, boys. Let's go. Let's go, boys. Bring it. Come on. Hey, guys. We need to start playing our game, okay? And we need to win this game. All right, guys? I'm not done today. Let's go. Dane's on 3. 1, 2, 3!
Dane! Sam Birmingham heads it into the back of the net, and the Danes have won it in extra time.
After winning their first 2 playoff games, the Danes traveled to the All-City Stadium in Denver to play against third-seeded Kip Denver Collegiate in the state quarterfinals.
It's going to be a very, very good game. It's going to be a pretty physical, I have a feeling, and because every single team in the tournament this far wants to get that much farther and go into semis and then finals. So it's going to be physical. It's going to be a really high-tempo game, and it's going to be a hard victory, and it's going to be a victory that we need to really make the seniors proud of us, the coaches proud of us, the entire school community proud of us, because I believe that we deserve it, and I believe that we deserve the state recognition that we will hold with the top dogs in the nation, and or the state, sorry.
For the first time since 2008, the Danes made it to the state semifinals.
So we're playing Coleridge in the semifinals. They're ranked 18 in the state of Colorado. We're ranked number 6, so we're higher, so we're expected to win. They've come in as a very strong team. They played first round against the second seeded team and beat them. Then they went and beat Salida, and now they're facing us in the semifinals. Coleridge is a very competitive team. I mean, they have a very fast offense, but our defense, I think, can control that. We've played against the top scorers in state already in this playoffs, and they've done a very good job in preventing that. We've gotten one goal against this whole playoff. Most of our players are very comfortable with the ball and very creative, and we just have to finish our opportunities in front of goal, and I think we'll be successful today. With 26 minutes left on the clock, Coleridge striker Sergio Valentine scored a breakaway goal. But moments later, Sam Birmingham did this.
Down 1-0 to Coleridge, senior captain Sam Birmingham took one for the team.
And I just got my chance, and I cut between two players and got fouled in the box.
Fellow captain Ian Strine knocked it home.
And only 3 minutes later, the Danes secured their spot in the state finals for the first time since 2007.
Dream come true, really.
Hold on, hold up to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady, a little unsteady. Oh, hold on, hold up to me, 'cause I'm a little unsteady.
Kept the game at 0-0 until the 63rd minute, when striker Max Gottesfeld of Kent Denver was tripped in the box. clock struck zero, Fountain Valley season ended as state runners-up, a feat that hadn't been achieved for 8 years. I'm living.